Hey, the accounting equation. I was just on my way out the door to go take a walk because it's a beautiful day, but one of my students just wrote me and is very confused about what we're doing. We were really comfortable with those statements, and now we're kind of confused because this is very tedious, isn't it? So let's go back to what we're talking about in the accounting equation. We need to understand that before we can do debits and credits. So the accounting equation is what we think of as the balance sheet equation. Assets must equal liabilities plus stockholders' equity at all times. No ifs, ands, or buts. So if we do something to one side, we have to do something that is going to negate that side, or we have to do something to the other side. So this equation stays in place. Always. The numbers may change during the month, but everything we do, every transaction we do, keeps it in balance. I'm very balanced. That's why I'm going to go walk now in a few minutes. So make sure you understand that assets equals liabilities plus stockholders' equity. Now, that's pretty simple, but what gets complicating is that stockholders' equity is made up of just two accounts, but they are very complex. So stockholders' equity is made up of retained earnings and common stock, and we know what they are. Common stock is what we sell to our stockholders, and they're an external source of funds. Retained earnings is what? What's the definition? The net income from the start of the business less any dividends. So, could we have a retained loss? Yeah, but hopefully we have retained earnings. Which that means it's a profitable business and we've retained that income in the business. So those two accounts belong to the stockholders, just as the liabilities belong to the creditors and the assets belong to the company. So we've talked about that before. So learn this equation and learn that every transaction we do, whether we sell something or buy something, it takes two accounts. An account is that term for cash or accounts receivable or revenue. It's the word. So there's no account called asset. There's no account called liability. They're always a specific account because we're trying to define this. Okay, we have that. So we can do a few samples for that. And I've done it based on Maggie's lemonade stand, like we were talking about in class. And it's really hard to tell here because I didn't do this dark enough and I was in a rush. So I issued stock for cash. That brought up my cash and it brought up my common stock. I'm in balance, same amount. I sold lemonade for cash. I got cash and I got revenue. Now, revenue, remember, is what? Part of net income. I should redo this page. And when I'm not in a hurry to get out and take a walk, I'll redo it. So I'm still in balance. Then I relieved the inventory. That means I sold the inventory actually for more than I paid for it. So I take the inventory down, and that's a minus to the inventory because it's going away. The asset's going down. And I call that cost of goods sold expense because I've actually used the inventory up, so it's cost something. So this is the cost of what that lemonade cost. So this is a cost, but that's not redundant. But then Maggie sells to customers on account, and she has an accounts receivable. I know you can't see that, but I know you're just listening to my voice. And then she also picks up some sales revenue because she made some lemonade sales. Am I still in balance? The whole time, still in balance. Then she buys a table on account because she's not having very much luck selling lemonade without a table or a stand. So when she does that, her assets go up again and she has an accounts payable. So assets equals liability plus equity must always stay in balance. We have that. That's the accounting equation. Now let's talk about the debits and credits.